I'm doing great. I'm tired, but I'm great. I just got back from Arlington. It's probably 5 o'clock in the morning. So yeah, I just got back. I just made it home. We touched down at 3 something. I didn't get home till 5. So yeah. I don't know, I was on the plane all day thinking like, bro, what could I talk about on my video? Because it's been a minute since I did one of these Killer Bees After Dark. So, here I am. Even though it's morning, but it's still dark. But anyways, I did one of these when I was in a hotel one night, just talking, and it was like 2 hours long, and I don't know if I'm gonna put that one up or not, but if I do, you'll know. But yeah, I don't know. Now that I'm back in Mississippi, it's like me taking these trips every week to go to Arlington and come back to Mississippi, and like it clears my head a lot, and I can't, like, I'm so grateful, because I sometimes tend to not be grateful for certain things, and I think that's what I'm going to talk about today. Well, tonight, this morning, this afternoon, whenever you decide to watch this. But I feel like I don't appreciate what I already have, because I feel like I don't have enough, and I need to be grateful for what I already have. I might not have all the money in the world, but I have some. I might not have the best clothes in the world, but I do have clothes on my back. I might not have the finest Jordans, but I do have shoes that I appreciate. I might not have a name brand vehicle, but I got one. I might not have a fancy apartment, but I have one. I might not have the best siblings, the best parents in the world, but I have parents. You get what I'm going with this? Be grateful for what you already have. Because you just don't know how easy it is, it can be taken away. Sometimes I sit back and wonder, like, was my uncle upset when he passed away and I couldn't be there when he did? Like, those are the things I think about. But then I have to think back in the good times. He knew what I was doing. He was proud of me for whatever I was doing. And I know now he's proud of me more than he ever have been. So, I'm like, be grateful for the things you do know, and work on the things that you want. But never be so ungrateful to the fact that you make other people feel bad for giving you something that you didn't want, but they think you need it. You know what I'm saying? Like, we get mad if we can't buy the finest shoes, or the finest Gucci bags, or get our nails and hair did every weekend. Be grateful that you have nails. Be grateful that you have hair. Be grateful that you're living the life. It might not be the life you want right now, but just be grateful you have one. Some people don't even have a house to live in. You should be grateful you got one. Some people don't even have a car to ride in. Be grateful that you got one. Some people can't even afford to get a job right now. Be grateful that you got the little part-time job you do have. It might not be the job that you want right now, but be happy with what you got. Don't be so ungrateful, because God can see, like, she is so ungrateful. She don't need this. And he can take it all away within the click of a button. Then you'll be so upset. I had this, but you didn't appreciate it, so it got taken away. Just long in the relationship. You can have the best person in the world, but they have the weirdest flaw. And you looking at yourself, I don't think I can deal with that flaw. And it's not even a bad flaw. They just don't fit into that little perfect caliber you think they do or you want them to. So you leave them. Then you get with somebody who is not the best. Who is a beast? Who talks down to you? And they have bigger flaws that you can't get through. Then you start running back to the person you was with. And they all have miniature flaws. Some you can just get rid of within a blink of an eye. But just because then and there they didn't fit in your perfect square, you didn't want them in your circle. Get what I'm saying? Most of us sit back and realize, and I'm guilty of this. We sit back and we complain of things we don't have. But we all have a thing. You don't have it now, but you will get it. Every time you have to just pray, speak everything you want into existence. It might not be there tomorrow. It might not be there in a month. But eventually, you will get it. And when you do get it, be grateful of who gave it to you. Because just like you got it, it can be easily removed. And I know some of us, we haven't learned this just overnight. We've been learning it. We just don't grasp it until the people we really need or the things we really need are gone. That's the way I look at things, though. So, yeah. Let's just take a look back and think about the things that we do have and the things we don't have. But, yeah, that's all I have for this video. It's not long, but at least I got my point across. Just be grateful for what you do have. But anyway, I just got home, and I have a lot on my mind right now. I feel like I have upcoming videos where people are not going to like what I say. Because I feel like I have been setting myself up for failure. I've been trying to please everybody else. I've been trying to make moves for everybody else. I've been trying to make moves for myself and make sure everybody else around me is happy. I feel like I let go of certain things that I should have just kept around me because I was trying to make sure the person or the people that was around me was comfortable or I didn't do something to overstep my boundaries or But now I'm at a point in my spirit that I'm just like, make myself happy. The people around me just can't be happy for me, then maybe they don't need to be in my corner. Maybe they don't need to be on my team. Maybe I just need to replace them. If I have people who don't want to be in my life, and I can feel when people don't want to be in my life, but I try to like, okay, maybe they have hardship in their life. Everybody have hardship in their life. But I also believe you make time for people who you want to be in your life. And lately I've noticed a lot of people not doing it. I always have to make sacrifices to make sure the people I'm with is happy. And I'm tired of doing that. I won't be doing it no more. You want me to call? You call sometimes. You want me to text? You text sometimes. A lot of people don't do that. A lot of people just wait on you. Hell, I'm waiting on me too. It's time for me to be selfish with what I want, because I've noticed a lot that I haven't been selfish with what I want, and I need to start there. I need to start doing that. I sit down with like some coworkers, and I feel like I grew closer to these coworkers because, hey, we eat together, we sleep together. That didn't sound right, but we have room had four, we had one suite with four rooms in it. So it was like, you see this person every day. You have to eat with this person every day. Because they got this whole buddy system. Since they think Virginia is like so bad that we have to have a buddy system. So, like, it's just crazy. If we go take a shower, one of us got to stand by the door. It's just crazy. Because the shower is not in the room, it's down the hallway. So, if we want to take a bath, we have to have somebody to walk down the hallway with us. They have to stand at the door. If, when we go in the room every day we get off work, we have to have two or three people with us to make sure there's no crazy people in the room. We call it crazy. So it's certain steps we have to go through to make sure of our safety. And I feel like those same steps we go through to make sure we're safe through business, we need to go through those same steps to make sure we're careful through our everyday life. Because everybody, I feel, have that person who you feel like is like your comfort. If it's your best friend, your boyfriend, your girlfriend, your parents, your siblings, your aunties, your godparents, we all have that one person to make you feel comfortable in everything you do. The one person you call, the one person you text, the one person you just spill your whole guts to. We all have that one person. So, yeah. I don't know. I just know sometimes we get outside of ourselves. And we just don't recognize the people we have in our life, what they do for us. We don't appreciate them enough. So, yeah. I think a lot of things are going to change for me this new year. I'm not saying that I want to be a better me, because I don't. I just want to be the same me, with the same attitude, just 1,000 times stronger than what I am now. Because I do have my weak moments to where I'm just like, bro, fuck this, I give up. Whole 2020, I feel like I done gave up at least 5 times. At least. But anyways, I'm definitely going to end this video. But, just know, I will check the description box because you'll never know what's inside. Make sure you guys check the description box. If you want to follow me on all my social medias, I need to go ahead and add Facebook back. So, somebody remind me in the comment section or just inbox me and say, hey, add your Facebook, because I'm going to forget. But, make sure you follow my social media. They are also in the box. Like I said, if you have any questions, make sure you put them in the comment section below. I am going to have this segment on my videos where I just have a Q&A about certain other topics that you guys asked me. So make sure you are paying close attention, because I'm going to try to stick the photo of your comment somewhere in the video. So yeah, just make sure you stay to the end. But I am going to answer this question that someone asked me in my inbox on Instagram. And they really didn't want to be in the video. I don't know why. But, and I'm not even sure if it's a he or she. But I think it was a stud. And I'm going to answer her question. The question that she had was, if I was to move, would I move to another state or somewhere in relationship wise? I feel like she was asking for herself, because I feel like somebody else don't ask me this. But listen to me. If anybody ever asks you to move, make sure you take the time out to ask yourself certain questions. Ask yourself, how would this move benefit me? Not just because you're moving for love or just because you want to see how the relationship work out. How would this trip or this move help benefit me? Would it help me go back to school? Would it help me get financially stable? How would this help me? Make sure you outweigh your pros and cons, okay? If I do move, make sure you also, if you do move, make sure you move into your own stuff. Don't move in with nobody else. That's the biggest thing you can ever do. The biggest mistake I feel like you ever do. Move from another state, you know nobody but the person you're going there for. And then when y'all get into it, y'all break up. Where you gonna go? Because I'm pretty sure people who move out don't want to go back with their parents. So, yeah. If you decide to move out, it's a lot of things you have to think about. Don't move just because your heart says you love them. You want to build a future with them. Don't do that. Let that be a part of why you're moving. But don't let it be the main reason why you move. If that makes sense. So yeah, that's my answer to that question. Now, would I move with someone that just asked me to move? No. Because to me, it's like, okay, prime example. My heart is stuck on Texas. I want to stay one to three years in Texas. But Texas is not a place I want a permanent move to, if that makes sense. I don't want to permanent raise my family, build my empire in Texas. So, I just can't not just move there just because I can't take my mindset off moving to Texas. If someone asked me to move to, let's say, South Carolina, I can't do that because my heart is set on Texas. I know in my mind my next move is going to be Texas. And my next move after that, it's my permanent move. I can't be with somebody. Okay, let's say I moved to Texas for somebody. Or let's just say I moved to, let's just say, okay, I moved to Texas and I find somebody to be with, right? And that person I be with, I ask them, hey, do you plan on staying in Texas all your life? And if they say, yeah, they're not leaving Texas because it's their hometown, understand me? I so understand that it's your hometown and you don't want to leave it. I understand it. But you also have to understand that we can't be together. To me, that's the biggest fault ever. Because that's me forcing myself to stay somewhere I really don't want to stay permanently. And I have to think about myself. I know some of y'all might be saying, that's selfish. Why you want to do that? Call me selfish. But I know what I want in life. I know what I need in my life. I want to get away from Mississippi, move to Texas, stay a couple of months or maybe a couple of years, and then go somewhere permanent. Texas is not my permanent stop. I mean, it's not my permanent stop. So, yeah. I know when I start dating someone, I ask them a million and one questions. But the only question I know I ever ask somebody is, do you plan on staying in your state forever? Or do you like to travel? Or are you very family oriented? Like, don't get me wrong. I don't mess with all my family like that because we all don't get along. And I'm pretty sure there's a lot of us out there that don't get along with their family like that. But my mom and dad, I love them to death, okay? So, yeah. But anyway, I'm going to end this video before we get too long. It's already sitting 30 minutes. But anyway, I'll talk to you guys in my next video. Thank you guys for joining my channel. If you have joined and you are new, you can always put in the comment section what videos you guys would like to see, what questions you guys would like me to answer. If you guys don't know, this is a life hack channel, meaning I talk about everything under the sun, what I think people might go through during life. Okay? So, yeah. I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.